Hi there. I hope all of you are doing great. Welcome once again to the Pep Talk. Today's topic is Catch 23 situation. Well, are you surprised? Are you amused? Are you confused? You must be thinking, what is the meaning of Catch 23 situation? Well, we have all heard about Catch 22 situation, right? So in Catch 22 situation, you don't know or you are basically confused. So for example, a newcomer passed out of college goes for an interview, and the interviewer asks him, well, I would love to give you the job, but you know what, can you tell me what experience do you have? He is in a catch 22 situation. He is new, he's just passed out of college, and he's asking, what experience do you have? So I'm sure you must be in catch 22 situation sometimes in your life. But today's topic is not about that. Today's topic is about catch 23 situation. Yes, catch 23. What does that mean? It only means innovation. Catch 23 to me is innovation. And what is innovation to me? Well, innovation to me is when you solve a problem, give a new meaning, and you change the world. Yes, you solve a problem, give a new meaning, and change the world. That is what is innovation. Now let me tell you a story. You know, before the 1970s, man had built cars, trucks, right? Supercar, fast cars, trains, flights, everything. They've even gone to space. But did you know that suitcases did not have wheels before the 1970s? So they had gone to space, they were flying in aircrafts, but they didn't have wheels in the suitcases. Think about it. It's only when they found that, my God, this is painful to carry luggages. It's so bad. You know, somebody innovated and put wheels on the suitcases. And guess what? The way we travel has changed since then completely, isn't it? Think about it. How much of a difference those wheels made. And before the 1970s, they weren't there. So I'm talking about those people who have these ideas, you know, to solve a problem, to change the world and give a meaning. Say for example, Apple, a company like Apple, the whole thing about mobile phones, tabs, iPads, computers, they've changed, they've added new meaning. They've changed the world. And to me, they're innovators. Google, information, you want any information, go to Google search and you can get it. So they've changed the world, they've added meaning, they've solved problems, you wanted information, they're making big money. eBay, the way you look at commerce and business, they've changed. YouTube, the way you look at videos, the way you put videos, watch videos, they've changed. Amazon, online delivery, they've changed everything about the world. OYO, our own OYO, the way hospitality was looked at, they've changed. Make My Trip, the way you book tickets, you can now compare, you can see the flight timing and the charges, and you know. Byju's, the way they've transformed learning. WhatsApp, the way they have transformed IM instant messaging chat. And Facebook, the way we virtually meet people and connect socially. Social networking, they have changed the world. They have solved problems. Uber, look at the problems we had finding a taxi. They've changed that also. So all the companies that I mentioned, right, from Apple, Google, eBay, YouTube, Amazon, OYO, Make My Trip, Byju's, Facebook, WhatsApp, Uber, and so on. You know, the thing is that if you have a product of value, you have a product of value, you have to compete on prices. Now, you have a product which is unique and has no value to anybody. That's not going to work. Again, you have a product which has no value and which has no uniqueness. Forget it. It's never going to work. But you have a product which is unique and it adds value. That's going to be the mantra for success. So when you talk about innovation, companies and businesses and individuals, when you want to make money, when you want to do big business or small business, whatever, global business, you start a business thinking I want to make money, huge money, you know, you actually don't end up innovating, you don't end up changing the world, you don't end up solving problems, trust me, you don't even end up earning any money. But when you think of a catch-23 situation and you start your business, that's when you think of innovation first, how to solve a problem, give a meaning and change the world, you actually end up making money. So that is what I wanted to share today about the catch-23 situation or innovation. So I'm sure, friends, that this video, like all my videos, is going to be useful for you. And I want to specially thank all of you for making the first ever Motivational Week, which was last week's 6 back-to-back videos, a big success. A big success. More than 3,000 viewers and more than hundreds of likes and shares and also comments and personal feedback. So I was very happy. Thank you for making it a success. And from your host, your dost, your friend, your mentor, Mr. Nag, Sudeep Nag, Brother Nag, Captain Nag, once again, bidding you a great day by saying goodbye and have a great, great day and wonderful time and be safe. Be safe. And before we go, let's do it together this time. Don't forget, let's do it together. Smile. Thank you.